Hello students, today in our video we will discuss more about the index mechanism. In our previous session we have already started the index sequential file organization, where the index mechanism is being added to the sequential file organization. So in the sequential file organization, what happens? Every records are stored in a particular sequence, in a specific order. Okay. So if the file storage is more, means file stores number of more now huge amount of records, so it will become a cumbersome process to manage all operations of the database, all database operations. So to search faster or fast response, to increase the response time, to minimize the response time, to provide instant result, we change this mechanism. A new technique, that is index technique or index mechanism, being added with the sequential file organization, so that the file organization used for index or become index sequential file organization. So in index sequential file organization, where index mechanism is added, where two files are being created, one is a data file and corresponding index file. So previous session we have discussed the structure of the index file, where a index field is there and corresponding pointer. These two fields will be used for index, to create the index file. So indexing, there are two types of indexing we have already explained. One is single level, another is multi level. Okay. So in the single level indexing, we have written the primary indexing, cluster indexing and secondary indexing. So today we will discuss all about this briefly. So in the primary indexing, what happens? Index mechanism or indexing, one is your primary indexing. So in primary indexing, what happens? The two field of index file was created. So one field is the sorted order of their primary key value. This is a sorted order of their primary key value. Another one is your cluster indexing. Third one is your secondary indexing. So these three important types of single level indexing that we have, one is your primary indexing, and a cluster indexing and secondary indexing. So in the primary indexing, what happens? The sorted, this is the sorted order of file. Indexing will be created on the primary key value or key value. Means we are using a key value plus order, sorted order of the file. File must be sorted, and we are using a key field for indexing. So here, in case of cluster indexing, it may be non-key value, and again it is a sorted order in cluster indexing. Okay. So in primary indexing, index is specified on the order of a key field. Okay. So each record has a unique value for that field in case of primary indexing. But in case of cluster indexing, what happens? The ordering field is not a primary key field. Several records in the file that can have the same value for ordering field. Okay. And in secondary indexing, there are not order file. File may be in order. Okay. The index is specified on any non-order field of a file. So here all fields are order. Key value which will be order. Non-key value which will be order. But in case of secondary indexing, it is a non-order. unsorted. Okay, so one by one we will go in details for these three types of indexing. Okay, so first today we will focus more about the primary indexing. Okay, where index file will be created. Index file will be created according to the sorted order of the key field value, means the primary key value. Okay, now let us discuss about the primary indexing. Primary indexing. So a primary indexing is an order of file. It is an order of file okay, whose records are of fixed length over two fields. Okay, one field is of same data type, means this is the order key field of the data file. Okay, so here order of file, and there will be a key value with key field value. Okay, so normally indexing, what happens? There are two field. There is already have discussed the structure of the index file. One is the there are two field. One is your key value, key field value here. Another is a block pointer. This is the key field value. This is the block pointer. Here the key will be the primary key. This is the primary key. And this is the address or location. Address of that particular record which is stored in data file. Okay. So second field is the pointer field to the disk. This is the pointer field. The pointer or pointer field addressed to the disk. Okay. In this way, we are using two fields whenever we are creating the index file. Another one is, this is the index file. This is the index file. Another one is the data file, where in the another file is the data file where all values, including this key field, primary key, will be stored. Okay. So according to, we only were searching from index file. Suppose we are searching for index file and finding the particular key field, then it is associated with the block pointer, that this pointer tends to the location where that record is being stored in the disk. Okay. Suppose you are searching for a roll number. Suppose we will give the example for a roll number. So only we are searching for roll number 101. So roll number 101 has got are associated with the block pointer. That pointer gives the location where that roll number 101, record of student roll number 101 or student bearing roll number 101 will be stored in the disk. So instantly it will point that particular location so that we can easily access or retrieve. Okay. Here ordering key field is the primary key of the data file. So here the ordering key field is the primary key of the data file. Okay. So this is the index file. There must be a data file. Data file is the key field, must be primary. It's the primary key. Okay. There is one order entry in the index file for each block. One, it may be considered disadvantage that suppose there is a data file, in data file 20 number of records are there. For 20 number of record, for each record, we have to create the index field. Means index file also contains 20 number of records. We have to create the index file containing 20 number of records. Let us consider one example for this. Suppose a student database. We are considering a student database. considering the student database. Okay, considering student database, where one block stores only 4 student records. This is the concept. And suppose there are 4 fields like roll number. Fields here, roll number, name, address, course. Roll number, name, address, and course. So here roll number is considered the primary. Suppose this is the data file. So this is the roll number, name, address, course. Suppose 101, name, address, course. 102, name, address, course. 103, name, address, course. 104, name, address, course. And so on. So there are 10 number of records in this data file. This is the data file where 10 number of students or 30 number of students. Okay, 30 number of students in a class are being created in the data file where 4 fields we are considering. Okay, so for this database we want to create the index file. Normally in index file has 2 fields. One is your block pointer. Again, in each block, suppose 3 number of records are there. This concept will be very clear in case of cluster indexing. Then there is a block pointer, and this is the key field. Key field. Okay. So here the key field may be your roll number. So 101 roll number, this is the block pointer. 102 is the block pointer. This is 103 block pointer. 104 block pointer. 105 block pointer. So this pointer gives the address of this one. This pointer this pointer 102, address of this one. Address of this one. So this one. This is the binary form. This is responsible of the operating system. So this is the index file. This is the index file. This index file contains 2 fields. This index file contains 2 fields. One is your key field. That is the primary key, which is the primary key in data file, as we consider here roll number. So only it stores roll number and block pointer. So whenever you are searching for roll number 102 or 124, so you are searching 124. Okay, so there are number of students. So only we have to search this 124 roll number in the index file. So by finding the 10124, roll number 124, then we can find the address. Then directly we will connect to that location where the all contents of this roll number, of this student roll number 124, will be extracted, will be accessed. So in this way, the index mechanism has been used in case of primary indexing. Here the key field is primary. Here the key field is primary. Clear my point? This is the concept of the primary indexing. So in primary indexing, what happens? Number of index entries. So here the number of records. Suppose you have 30 number of records. So again, it has to create 30 number of records in this index file. Okay. That means number of index file equal to number of records or number of blocks. That means each record, there must be index entry. For each record, there must be index entry. Also, we can have two types of indexing. One is your dense indexing, another one is sparse indexing. So, in case of this, the example of dense indexing. Here, for each record, it is created a record key value or for index entry. Index entry is created for each record. For each and every record, there must be index entry. Index field is created. Okay. So number of access required here. The number of access required here. Just remember this one. So number of access required equal to number of access required equal to log n base 2 plus 1. This is a formula. It is already verified, where n be the number of blocks requiring the index file. So here n is the number of blocks. So it is verified. Also you can do. Okay. If n is the number of blocks, so if n is the number of blocks, suppose you block 3 records. So how many are each record? This may be block, this may be block, this may be block. So log n base 2 plus 1. This may be the access required. Okay. This is the number of access required. So private indexing may be, again, it may be dense or it may be sparse. Okay. It may be dense or it may be sparse. Okay. So if for each and every record, there must there is a created index field. That means it is dense indexing. Okay. So now let us discuss about the example. For the dense indexing, okay. It is a primary key, primary indexing. Now let's do the dense indexing. Okay. So here each record key, each source key, each data file must have a index entry. For example, we are considering an account. Okay. A account where account number, branch and balance are there. Suppose file account database, where account number, branch name, then balance. Okay. So this is the account database file. So three fields are entered below in the data file. Okay. So just enter in this way. So there is a so there are 100 number of records. Just getting the previous address. So this is the data file. It is stored in the hard disk. This is the data file. So as for dense indexing, we have discussed that for each record, a index field is created. Means there is an index entry for each and every record of the data file. Suppose there are 100 number of records. So 100 number of index entry will be created while creating the index file. Okay, while creating the index file. So suppose source key we are considering here, account number, because this account number may be considered as the primary key. So while creating index file, this is your data file, okay, this is your index file. While creating the index file, so two field will be there. And the key field is the primary key. Here the example of account number and block pointer. Okay, block pointer. So here account number will be, suppose 101, SC 101, so this is SC 101, the block pointer. This pointer, that is the block. Similarly, 102, this is the block pointer. So here, how many index entries will be created here? 100 number of index entries. So this is the index file, this is the data file. So if 100 number of records are stored, means for each record, the index value will be created. Means 100 number of records if you are storing in data file. So 100 number of index file, index entry will be created in index file. This is nothing but the dense indexing, because for each record of database file there must be created the index entry. Means there must be index entry for each record of the data. So we are creating index entry for each and every source key value. Okay. So here where a source key value is, we are considering the account number. So if 100 number of account numbers are stored in this data file, so 100 number of account number will be stored also in the index file. So this is the example of dense indexing. Okay, this is the example of dense indexing. This is the primary key, because this is the primary key. Again, we can use according to while requirement is needed that the sparse indexing. Okay, not this example, but sparse indexing. Okay. So in sparse indexing, what happens? There is for each and every our index entry will be created only for some of the records, not all. If index entry is created for all records, then it is a dense indexing. If index entry is created for some of the records, that is the sparse indexing. Sparse index. And there is a block, it will be created a block. Suppose this is a block. Suppose a block containing 3 or 4 number of records. This is a block 1. This is again, this is a block 2. Another 3 records will be there. 3 or 4 records will be there. This is your block, another block will be there. This is your block. The number of blocks are there. The number of blocks are there. So block 1 contains of the 4. 102, 103, SC, this is SC, 104. So 4 records. 4 records are stored in block 1. Then suppose account number 201, account number 202, account number 203, account number 204. Okay? Then suppose in block 3, account number 301, account number 302, account number 303, account number 304. In this way, this is the block 1, this is the block 2, the block 3. So for block 1, there is an anchor record, means first record. This address will be created for index entry. Okay, this address field will be created for index entry. So here the index file, here the index file is created not for all records, not for all records. So this is the account 201. In this way, and for 201. So this is a data file. There is a number of blocks are there. For first record of the block, for the record which is stored in the first record, that record, for that record the index entry will be created. So here for block 1, only index 101, index for 101 record, record no, account number 101 will be created. Similarly in block 2, account number 201 and 301. So instead of creating all index entry for all records, only some of the records, only index entry is, index value, index entry is created only some of the records. Means number of blocks in the data file, that much only the index file will be created in case of index file. Okay, your search key also we are considering the, your search key also considering the account number. Okay, account number is the search key. That means this is the anchor record. Anchor record is the first record of the block. So whenever searching account number 101, it will search for this. Again, this is sorted order. So we know that after completion of 101, then 201 will be started. And for each block, we are considering, suppose, 4 records. So if you are searching 103, then what happens? So whenever searching for 103, record number 103, so first it will be 101. It will be in this block, 101 block. If you are searching 205, so 205 is not there. So we cannot search. So if you search 202, so 201 is there, the account number 202 will be stored in the block 201. Okay. So accordingly we can search. So index file will become reduced here. Okay. So index file is become reduced. Suppose you are searching 303. So instead of searching 101 and 201, directly you can go for 301. Because 301 maybe the anchor record for the block where account number 303 is present. This is the logic behind it. Instead of searching each record, instead of searching all records, only there is some index mechanism so that we can easily search, we can easily access that particular record. Okay. Suppose there are number 1000 number of, there are 4000 number or 400 number of blocks are there. So in 400 number of blocks, there are 400 into 4, 1600 records are there. If 1600 records are stored in data file and we are using the dense indexing, so 1600 number of index entry will be created. So while searching 1600 number of index record, it will be time taking. So instead of creating 16 number of index entry, only we can create 400 number of index entry. So from 4 number of index entry, we can easily search, we can easily find out. Okay. So this is the mechanism, and in this way, we can search, we can reduce the timing, response time. We can reduce the response time, and easily we can search. Okay. So instead of searching more number of records from data file, we will will create the index file, and where for some of the records the index file index entry will be created. So for four a number of records one index field is being created. For one account number 101, account number 102, and account number 103, and account number 104. For this four number of records, there is only one index is entered. It is generated or created at the account 101. So by searching 101, we can go for this. Then we can again follow the sequential search, because this is the index sequential file organization. We are studying the index sequential file organization. Here index file organization, index mechanism will be added, will be used, and sequential file also used. So to search the anchor record, first record of the block, we are using the index mechanism. Then from here again we are using the sequential file organization. So sequential mechanism as well as index mechanism is being used, just like a dictionary. Okay, in a dictionary what happens? Letter number A is page number 1. Letter number B, suppose page number 1111. Okay, so whenever you are searching a record, a word that is started from that started with B, then we can directly go to 1111. Okay, so in the dictionary, suppose alphabet A, try to understand. Suppose alphabet A is page number 1. Now alphabet B, suppose 111. C, suppose 2222. Okay. So whenever you are searching a word that is started with B, so directly you can access this one. Directly you can go to page number 1111, then we can search sequential. Suppose a letter started with C, then directly you can go page number 222, then we can search sequential. So in this way, we are using these two types of indexing, that is sparse indexing and dense indexing, which is the primary key. This index mechanism is the primary key indexing, because this index mechanism is based on the primary key. So here the source key field is the primary key. Okay, the source key field is the primary key. So that is the primary indexing. Okay, so this is the primary indexing. And also there is another two types of indexing in there. One is your cluster indexing, another one is your secondary indexing. We will go to study. Okay, so watch this video and try to understand the concept of primary indexing and why index mechanism is being used in database file. Okay, and the description or note for this topic will be sent to your group, and if you doubt, you can send me question or you can ask me. Okay, thank you for watching this video. Okay, so watch for next video, that is a cluster indexing and secondary indexing. Okay.